smoking is kind of a hard thing to do. So I guess we'll make that the discussion topic for today. I picked up smoking when I was 17 and a half years old. June of 2012. I was out of the house for a few weeks. A friend of mine knew that during that time I was going through a bit of a rough patch and offered me a cigarette. So I said no, that changed. I started with god-awful novel that I turned to Senefe's. I like cigarettes better than cigarettes. During my pregnancy, I used to drink a lot of peppermint tea. I've heard people tell me that peppermint helps with not smoking. I didn't crave it as much. I actually quit smoking a few weeks before I even found out that I was pregnant. Actually, a little over a month. So for 10 months, I was clean. And that was my fourth try. Something came up. And I broke. Well, when we moved, the last folks who lived here, instead of putting that little air filter into the little slab it's supposed to go in, they actually put it on top of everything. It had a lot of dust, and when we started up the whole air system in the house, it blew everywhere. Just like my mom, I have a severe dust allergy. I knew the dust was playing a part, but I thought it was a small part. It's not really one of those things that used to bother me as much as it does now. Having a child, it changed me. You know, I could be wrong. I could be totally bullshitting myself. I don't know. You know, smoking, it's something that consumes you. Once you allow that into your life, it's hard to get rid of. It's difficult to explain. Usually it's only other smokers that understand. When I'm smoking, I don't usually think about it. You think to yourself, oh hey, yeah, you know, this isn't such a bad thing. It makes you feel good. In reality, when you're holding the cigarette, the idea of pulling something harmful into them, such as nicotine, is no longer taboo, but rather something quite acceptable. However, thankfully, there are some people that do try to argue it. There are places that do not allow smoking within certain areas. However, some still try to accommodate those of whom do smoke. They realize and understand the dependency that it causes. You get in the habit of it. Your cravings up like 20-fold. You go to have a cup of coffee and you're looking for your cigarettes or filling in your pocket for them, and then you realize, oh yeah, I'm not smoking anymore. It's difficult to get away from. When you try to quit, you just have to bite down on the bullet and go with what you have. You've made the decision to quit, so you have to stick with it. Oftentimes, it seems that many start smoking as teenagers. To break such a habit can be rather difficult. Many claim to undergo feelings of anger, frustration, as well as being depressed. It's not an easy transition at all, and can even cause hardships and harsh feelings within friendships and families. If you know someone who is trying to quit, don't give them a hard time about how they act or react. If someone offers you a cigarette, the best decision I could tell you to make, say no thank you. Ask yourself, are they really a friend? One of your friends is trying to pressure you into smoking. If they're going to pressure you into something that's going to hurt you, choose not to leave with the cravings. Money out of your pocket that could go towards your gas, towards your food, pets, anything. Medical friends, everything. And if they're real friends, they're going to apologize. Never ask you again. If they aren't, just try it. And they're going to get shitty with you. As they do, it's just a cycle. What the fuck? And they're going to keep pushing you and pushing you and pushing you. They're going to put you through what they were put through. So, if you're offered one, say no. If you're smoking one right now, for me, please put it out. Piece of gum in your mouth. Eat some of the minty detox or Mentos. When you're quitting something, after the first 3 days, it's easy. Your body can handle it. After the third day of me smoking, it was like 7 inches. After the third day of me quitting each time, but it's only as hard as you make it. As easy as you make it. Thank you. If you have any ideas or requests, you can, follow this little link that I'm going to try and have trailing across at the bottom of the screen at this moment. Post your request. I don't know if you can inbox me on YouTube. I'm not sure. I'll have an email that you can send requests to. This is for you to use.